life when she's dealing with people on the internet being assholes. Like, I get it. And they are still fucking adorable together.
Absolutely.
I saw that video of him pretending to be Chris Brown.
Doing a cheer for my mom.
It was a white woman from DoorDash delivering two big-ass bags of food to their house. And she was like, why do you seem familiar? And
he lied.
He said, my name's Chris Brown. I used to sing a little bit. And then he said, he's your man. Yes, he did.
He revealed the aircraft via his IGTV. It's a thing the girls use these days, where you can
make videos
much longer than they need to be.
Okay.
Shout us.
It's just YouTube or Instagram.
I mean, he showed it off in his little hangar and them peeling the decals and showing that shit off and shit. Says air draped along the side as well as his owl.
Oh, of course it does. The OV owl.
And I didn't know that the praying hands that were on, I guess that's his like logo or symbol.
The same Black Jesus praying hands?
Yeah.
That have been on every like church fan and program and all that. Them same hands.
He uses them on everything, I guess now.
Okay.
I guess it's like, it might be a, I don't know.
My mama won't like that. When she said anything that where rappers insinuate that they are associated with Jesus or Christianity, my mama immediately is like,
no, she believes in praise.
No, she don't.
She just believes in praise.
Oh, praise in the praise of who? Everybody's on your plane.
Praise God.
Praise God, and that's it.
Exactly.
No.
And it's so close to, because he's so high up. It is aircraft.
All right.
Well, apparently he's also the ambassador of this Canadian airline called Cargo Jet that does, like, your cargo jet rentals and private fancy nigga shit. I don't know. But he's the ambassador for them now. They're excited, too. I don't really know what that has to do with this plane. Maybe they shaved a couple million off of it.
Okay, yes,
I don't know.
Just come on a plane. That makes sense.
But CBS News says, according to Airways Magazine, that those types of planes cost about $185 million before you get them customized. So, you know.
Oh.
I'm sorry. What?
The Dodson is having a great time.
$185 million.
Flying back and forth to Jamaica for as much festival as they want.
$185 million for an airplane.
Things. A champagne room.
There we go.
Probably as well as, you know, other luxury things.
Right.
I assume that Adonis will get a sibling in there at some point. We're going to have one conceived.
Right.
Why not?
Because do you need an NDA when you're 30,000 feet? I don't know
what I'm talking about. No, you don't.
I don't know.
Something
like that. Next. This is cute. This is very for Drake. He's worked hard for a long time. If anything, you know, shoot a cool video in it.
I mean, right. Like, nigga, this is my plane. This is my airplane.
I just thought he shoots, like, a really luxurious video in it. With,
oh, absolutely.
Every one of his new favorite strippers.
Absolutely. But for $185 million, I'm going to need a pilot to come with that bitch. And gas for at least the first 5 years.
Catering.
All that shit. I should not have to pay out of pocket for it. You got gas too. Yes. We're not paying for the fucking gas either. No. $185 million.
You just buy a shell?
You know how many homes you could get? Like, that is so much fucking money.
And all the homes?
Wow.
And he just also got a residency in Vegas somewhere with some fancy hotel or whatever.
I mean, I know Drake is rich, but Jesus, that is a huge chunk of money. Like, $185 million is a lot of money.
Assuming. I mean, they're just saying that's around how much those jets cost.
Right, doesn't
Mama could have
paid.
Right.
He could have been gifted it for all we know. But damn. You know what? I'm not mad.
Because Carl and Drake could have said, look, just be our ambassador. Tell the girls you live.
Yeah.
Okay. And we'll chop off a strong $100 million.
Right. They probably gave him like a 75% discount for being associated with the airline or what the.
Because we're talking about a company I would have never heard of.
Right.
Otherwise.
Air Cargo Canada? What the fuck?
Get that nigga his plane. I mean, yeah. Who cares?
What do they do? Shit maple syrup and shit down here? Hockey gloves and shit? What do they even do? Give him his fucking dollars.
Boots. You know,
we need boots.
Those tall hats and Pirellos.
Gotta be something out here with these boots.
I don't know why that made me think of when Nick Cannon wore that beauty supply hair wrap to the VMA.
Oh, she wore those a lot.
Were you still wearing them $2 hair wraps? Them turbans that you get at the beauty supply, so they don't even look good. They just. There. You like, nigga, what are you doing?
Did he ever upgrade them?
I don't know. I think maybe he stopped fucking white women and he stopped wearing them.
Cool.
I don't know for sure. Because you know he said fucking white women is his birthright. Because his daddy's just...
So anyways, this, what an interview.
I think it was the last time I heard Nick Cannon speak. I really do think it was.
That was an odd day.
Don't you want some wine?
It goes really good with that.
Does it? With that cup. It does.
I don't even know where this wine came from.
It came from my backpack.
Oh, okay. That makes sense.
No, I brought it because it's already open and it's not going to still be good on Sunday because it's cheap. So,
drink it now. That's a great one. I just get that $8 wine and finish it.
I mean, this is $12.99, so don't think I'm some fancy bitch. And I love it, too. I will fuck that wine up.
Delicious. Like... I don't give a fuck when none of these hoes tell you.
I wasn't into wine until I was like 29, 30 years old. Same. It took a long time.
Especially
wine.
A red one?
Right.
Like, now I love it.
Bitch, old grapes? Are you kidding?
What the fuck is wrong with you?
I would rather have bottom shelf vodka.
Pass the Crevassier.
Crevassier. I've never been rich enough in my life for that shit.
Speaking of Drake introducing us to strippers, Black China has used this weekend to tell all. The freelance girlfriend and ex-rapper appeared on Wendy Williams' show.
Something like this.
And on the heels of hot new drama, where her soon-to-be ex-hairdresser claims that she came at her with a knife outside of her home and tried to attack her. Apparently, Black China is in the middle of litigation with that. There was some surveillance video from the incident that came out showing the hairdresser throwing allegedly soda cans or something at Black China's car. Black China then comes out in what looks to be a robe or something, throws her shoes at her because, of course. But there isn't really a knife that's shown in the camera. Not to say that the girl's lying or whatever, but... We'll do with that.
If a bitch is throwing cans at your property, how do you not immediately call security? Does Black China not have security?
Black China has hands, so I don't know.
Okay, I guess.
She also went on there and talks about whatever. She talks about her whole history, everything that happened with Tyga. Not knowing that Tyga was. Literally, she talked about stripping, what part of her body is real and what's not, her mama being mad at her and why.
Oh, mama, goddamn.
There we go. I'm not fucking retarded.
You know, being thrown out of Tiger's house when he started dating Kylie at 17. Trying to
out of nonsense, because that is
a dream. A simple fantasy. Da, 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 da.
Still has his bag. He's still hosting Family Feud. Feud, I'm sure. He's actually very good at hosting Family Feud. His reactions and his nigga shit and his suits are perfect for that show.
Yeah, he's very good for
Steve. But Steve Harvey never had any business with a talk show, especially telling women how to act or how to be wives or godly or any fucking thing else. That never needed to happen in the first place. So I can't say that I'm shedding any tears over this cancellation.
Steve Harvey's show to me in my mind was like Black Dr. Phil.
Except even more bullshit.
Yeah.
Because at least, oh wait, no, Dr. Phil was not actually a doctor. Goddamn, I don't think he was.
Right.
I don't think he was. Okay, it might be worse because the white man called himself a doctor when he wasn't. And yeah, you know, I think Dr. Phil is worse. I do. Because he also puts a lot of shitty mess into the world. And his people don't have no morals or ethics.
But that's what a lot of those daytime shows are.
Yeah.
Like, I saw a clip randomly today as I was on YouTube of Maury, where he had two niggas from the MTV challenges on there doing lie detector tests, like, from some shit on the season or something.
What?
Like, Maury, why? Like,
what kind of MTV?
What is this? Like,
what is this?
You seem like a smart white man. You didn't invest? Like, you can just be done. You can retire. Like, why are you doing this? I know you don't care.
Right. To keep Connie Chung, you know, in the salon. Well, she like a manicure and a pedicure, okay, every week.
And let me tell you something. It's non-negotiable.
It's non-negotiable, Maury. I can be by myself, all right? Broke alone. Woo, honestly, me as a wife.
Meanwhile, over in Lee Daniels' Fox World Empire, their next season, the sixth season, will reportedly be its last. Mm-hmm. And much to the ire of plenty niggas in my life, Star has also been canceled. Ooh,
yes, now the niggas were very upset about Star.
There's a petition.
Of course they
put their foot down,
of
their feet
course.
To the ground.
Unfortunately, Star is a very expensive show to produce.
I'd imagine.
You have a lot of high-dollar talent on it and the music aspect of it. Like, it's not cheap to do that. So, I understand it, but I'm sorry because, of course, they end up on, like, multiple cliffhangers and all this, and people will just never know how.
That's always...
That is the worst.
The worst, yes.
I wish everybody would do their season as if they anticipated it being the last season. Like, even though I understood why Pose did that. I'm like, Pose, girl, you should have known that she was coming back. They're just perfect. But right. Pose wrapped it up to where that
there's
was
no reason
it,
for it. Yeah, it's not like a close. It's not like, oh my god,
I'm so confused.
I did
right
not
now.
See this coming back. Right, like it felt right. like the end to a story that
yes.
they had written like particularly for that.
Right.
But even if they did it, you're
could
right.
easily pick it back up.
It was like,
else,
oh, that was a nice.
Right. It won't leave you like, damn, what happened to her? What happened to her?
And there are ways to have cliffhangers that aren't like, oh my god, bitch.
Right.
Like, no, you cannot.
Like Patti LaBelle got shot. Bitch, what? Don't leave me on that. Bitch, what? Yeah, my Instagram was furious about this. Nobody cares about this being Empire's last season. I think we all agree Empire should have probably ended a while ago, but niggas are real hurt about this Star thing.
Yeah, I mean, I've had niggas
that does something,
in my
but...
personal life go out of their
I know,
way to convince me that I need to be a starlet or whatever the series are called. And I just, like,
we're
a lot
here.
Of the music is great.
Don't know.
Like I said, so a couple of friends is probably where they spend
good luck with this chair, Mom. I'm so scared.
So,
oh my
I mean,
god, I'm
I can
right.
agree that, you know, they do make some great
okay,
music, but having a web, I saw someone refer to it as the red bottom wedding.